This is Dan representing Youth Voice Collaborative once again, and we just caught some beautiful haddock, some cusk, and what we're going to do today with Chef Kenny is going to cook some of the, actually not the cusk, I'm going to take care of that with the recipe that Giacomo gave me on the boat. But for the haddock, we have Chef Kenny. Can you tell us a little bit about yourself and how long you've been cooking? Chef.
Okay, I've been cooking professionally for about 15 years. I've always cooked, my mother taught me how. But I've been doing that for the last 15 years. And today we're going to take the fish that you caught and turn it into a nice, healthy, easy-to-make, delicious meal that'll have no cleanup. So, we're going to have fun.
All right, thanks. All right, cool. So, now...
Hold up.
Out of the shot.
For the children, you know, the children. All right. So now... Actually, this is not a bad shot at all. So if you can, again, just go right ahead. And yeah.
Okay, we're going to take this nice haddock that you guys caught, and a couple of nice carrots. This is a Chinese vegetable. It's like bok choy. It's called yak choy. You can use spinach, which is easier to get, and some potatoes. I have some lemon pepper, which is very delicious with fish, some salt, because the lemon pepper is salt-free, and I have some olive oil. We're gonna wrap that all in some foil, pop it in the oven. When you're done, you're gonna take it out, slide it on your plate. There'll be no cleanup. You take the foil, throw it away. Sit down and eat a great meal.
Beautiful. Yeah, just hold it for a little bit. Beautiful. Just keep doing what you're doing.
We're gonna actually take this foil here. Hold on, let me get another surface here. Very simple. If we put the foil right on the pan, we're gonna put it in. We'll take our greens, which if it was spinach, all you want to do is really just chiffonade them, cut them slightly to the side on an angle so you can have a bed to rest your fish on. The greens will wilt down when you cook them, and they'll be nice and delicious. So you're going to take some of the greens, very easy here, just pop them on the foil. Same with the other one, just pop it on. Right? You always want to salt and season each layer because your flavors have to come through. So put a little bit of salt. All right? Then you want to take your carrots. Yeah, your carrots. And you can slice those thin, very thinly. All
right.
Okay. So you want to take your carrots and slice them on a bias. Okay? Because you want them thin enough to cook and not be crunchy. The worst thing you want to do is have crunchy vegetables when everything else is nice and tender and delicious. And once you cut, you should want to take some, both servings, little carrots in there. Just a little crunch, a little color, more nutrition. Okay, very tasty. Carrots get sweeter as you cook them. So, that's a really nice thing. And they don't lose any of their nutritional value. Okay, then you want to just take a potato. I like a potato with the skin on it, because I think the skins are very good for you. Slice it thin. And just put a couple of pieces of potato in each one. I put three in this one, and I put three now. Another potato. And you definitely want to put salt on the potato because potatoes need salt. Then you just want to take your fillets, each one, and lay it here. Lay it right on top of everything. Alright.
Do me a favor, can you just make the tin foil is blocking it, so if you can just flatten the foil out a little bit. Yeah, there it goes.
Alright. And just take your fillet and lay it right on top of it. If you need to curl up the end, that's fine. Perfect.
Okay.
Okay.
Cut for a sec. I'm just gonna take this and just get a shot from above.
Okay.
Oh wow, that looks good, man.
It's really easy. It's really simple.
That looks really good. Cause I was seeing it from the side. Let me just get like a close up of each. Damn, that looks good, dog.
Okay, and it's very so easy to make.
Cool. You're on.
Okay, now you want to put a little bit of olive oil on. And you can, olive oil is a healthy oil, so don't be afraid to use it. It's very good for you out of all the oils that you use. Okay? A little bit of salt, because you need to fillet on, season your fillet. And if you're using kosher salt, it's really important to use kosher salt as opposed to iodized salt.
Okay, say that one more time.
It's very important to use kosher salt when cooking as opposed to iodized salt, the regular table salt. It doesn't dissolve. Okay?
Can you do me a favor?
Sure.
For us black folks, is there a health benefit to that fact right there?
Yes.
Okay, can you make that into a point?
Yeah. The thing about salt is that people don't get is you shouldn't really taste the salt. Salt should flavor your, bring out the flavors in your food. If you taste the salt, there's too much salt in it. Okay, and I think that African Americans, myself included, are salt freaks. We love salt. Okay, and it's really not good for you. It drives your high blood pressure up. It's just not good for you. So you need to watch your salt level. Really important, because hypertension is a major killer of African Americans.
Excellent. So anytime you remember something like that, throw it in. But okay. You're rolling.
Okay, well, I just use a little bit of salt to bring out the flavor. And my other seasoning is the lemon pepper, which is salt-free. And it's basically black pepper and lemon rind. You want to get a nice healthy amount of that on it, because that's really a good flavor for your fish. Okay, and you can either put a couple of slices of lemon in, like people do, and that will flavor your fish also. There's a couple of slices of lemon right in there. Cut it really thin. You can lay it right on your fish.
Just pause for a sec. I'm just going to come in and get another shot from above.
Okay?
Yep, so you just keep doing what you
do. And this is your final product before it goes in the oven. And it's very simple. You just want to take your foil and wrap it in a package. All you're doing, see how you fold it completely down, seal it. That's it. Fold it completely over like that. Seal it up. Oven's preheated at 350. That's the first thing you need to do when you start cooking. If you're baking in the oven, make sure you preheat your oven, because then the rest of the process is done. By the time your food is ready, after you finish preparing it, you can pop it right in the oven, like we're going to do. 350 for about 15 to 20 minutes. We'll open it up, it'll be steaming, everything will be tender, and we'll have a good meal. Now we're going to take...
You're rolling.
Okay, now we're going to take our product out of the oven, and we'll see what we've produced. Okay. Foil's a little hot, but it doesn't seem to bother me.
It's rolling.
Okay. Now, the object is, see, our greens are nice and wilted and cooked. Our potatoes are tender to the fork. Our carrots are done, and our fish is completely done. So we're going to take this, slide it right off onto the plate. Just slide right out. Very easy there. There's your cleanup. Done. No cleanup. There's your meal.
Let me just stand there like that. Okay. All right. And can you just make one last statement?
Okay. Now, once again, I just want to reiterate that we took the fresh haddock that you caught. We used some fresh greens, some potatoes, some carrots. The seasoning was just some lemon pepper, a little bit of olive oil, which is a very healthy oil for you. There's no butter in it, very little bit of salt. The salt is just to bring up the flavor of the food. And the main seasoning is the lemon pepper and some fresh lemon on top. So here you got a fresh, healthy meal. It's really easy, very delicious.
Let me just get another shot of that. Looks good, that looks good. Excellent.